If you draw up a map, trace a line connecting the island of Bermuda, Puerto Rico, Miami, and back to Bermuda, what do you get? The infamous triangle, known for swallowing thousands of ships and aircraft over the centuries. But there's a new mystery to this already enigmatic place. Something's lurking deep in the waters below, and it's leaving bizarre clues of its existence. Splash! Your submarine hits the water's surface. You descend 100, 1,000, 2,000, 3,000 feet. It's getting darker. The sub's walls creak as the pressure grows. Over 1,400 psi. It's like the weight of a grand piano squeezing every square inch of your body from all sides. You've made it to your destination. All that's left is to spot the beast. Just in time, among the black void, you see a bright green glow off in the distance. It's getting closer. As it approaches, it gets bigger. This is it! The creature that's been leaving strange circular markings on fish, dolphins, whales, and even other sharks. Behold, the cookie cutter shark! Don't let its size fool you. It may be no longer than a bowling pin, but this creature is a parasite. It attaches itself to other marine animals using its neatly arranged, serrated teeth. With one bite, it fills its belly, detaches, and goes on about its day. Its mobile snack also swims away with its life. The only evidence of this rendezvous, a cookie-shaped mark on its body. Don't assume you're safe in your submarine. These bold little guys have been known to go after subs, too. You decide not to risk the shark punching a hole in the only thing keeping you from being squished to a pulp by the surrounding water. You journey on to meet other bizarre creatures lurking in the Bermuda Triangle. At twice the depth, you'll find the dragonfish. Unlike other deep water inhabitants, these things produce light in the infrared range. Blue and green is what other fish stick to. This gives the dragonfish a huge advantage. It provides itself with light that other marine dwellers just can't perceive. Things that want to eat the dragonfish can't detect this light, as well as the critters the dragonfish likes to feed on. A truly unique deep sea dweller is the vampire squid. Neither vampire nor squid, or octopus, this thing is a unique species of its own. It has the largest eyes compared to body size of any animal on the entire planet. When the vampire squid feels threatened, it curls its arms up and around its body. Essentially, the thing turns itself inside out. Another animal to avoid down here is the terrifying bobbit worm. It buries itself in the seafloor, leaving a small part of its body out. It waits for dinner time with its pincer-like mouth parts open. What's on the menu? Other worms and fish that can be 7 times bigger than the bobbit. It uses its 5 antennas to sense when lunch is close enough to snap. In an instant, the worm launches forward and grabs its lunch with its mouth parts. It's not done yet. Once it's got its jaws locked onto its lunch, the worm injects it with venom and pulls it down into the burrow to feast. One of the deepest trenches in the Bermuda Triangle is the Tongue of the Ocean. This is also the secret breeding grounds of tiger sharks. You'll instantly recognize them thanks to those darker gray tiger stripes on their sides. They're the second largest predatory shark species after the great white. And with a big size comes a big appetite. Marine mammals, smaller sharks, stingrays, and green turtles are all on the menu. If you ever come face to face with a tiger shark, hopefully not, remember this. You can tell the fish's age by looking at its stripes. They fade over time, so the younger the shark, the more pronounced its stripes. There's plenty of zooplankton in the Bermuda Triangle. These are, usually, small organisms that are essential to the ocean's food chain. But get this, if nothing ate them and they were left to grow out of control, zooplankton would cover the entire world in layers and layers in just 4 months. Oh, and the largest type of zooplankton is the jellyfish. jellyfish were around long before dinosaurs. You probably know your body is 60% water. A jellyfish is 95%. So if it gets washed onto the shore, after a few hours, most of its body just evaporates into the air. There's also a jellyfish that lives forever. The immortal jellyfish can revert itself back to its polyp stage and then grow again. Sounds like something from another planet, but it's no space jelly. Those do exist, by the way. Back in the 1990s, NASA raised jellyfish in space to see what zero gravity does to them. They were just fine living up there in the cosmos. When they came back down to Earth, though, they had trouble adjusting. The European eel hasn't been to space, but it is quite a globetrotter. It travels all the way from Europe to the Sargasso Sea, where the Bermuda Triangle is located. In the larval stage, it just drifts around the ocean for as long as 3 years sometimes. It's also the chameleon of the sea. Over the years, the European eel changes color, going from translucent to yellow to metallic silver. They're nocturnal and secretive, pretty much the ideal companion to have when you raid the fridge at midnight. A giant squid over half the length of a football field once washed up on a Florida beach. Researchers suspected this behemoth came from the Atlantic Ocean near the Bermuda Triangle. Giant squids are the longest invertebrates, meaning they have no backbone. They also have the biggest eyes on Earth, ever. They're as large as a soccer ball. Another creature found near the Bermuda Triangle is Starer's cave shrimp. They were so good at keeping to themselves that no one knew these creatures even existed until 2011. Some female cave shrimps carry an impressive number of eggs along with them. Scientists discovered one female had around 2,000 eggs attached to her body. The Bermuda petrel is the national bird of, yes, you guessed it, Bermuda. It's the second rarest seabird on the planet. In fact, people thought it was extinct until 1951, when they spotted a few on the island. It has an eerie cry that'll send shivers down your spine. The Nassau grouper can only be found on the coasts of South Florida. This fish lies in wait and ambushes its lunch of other fish, crabs, and lobsters. It's sort of like a vacuum cleaner because it inhales its food through its huge mouth. The fish has a cool defense mechanism too. Like the chameleon, it changes color when it feels it's in danger. Sometimes it takes on a lighter or darker shade of its own color to blend in with the environment. So, you may spot a Nassau grouper, or you may not. If you happen to visit the Bermuda Triangle, you'll probably see a hammerhead shark. They use that iconic hammer-shaped head to pin their lunch, stingrays, onto the ocean floor. The shape of their head also gives them better vision. They can see almost 360 degrees all around, above and below them. Well, save for one blind spot right in front of their nose. The hawksbill sea turtle may not look intimidating, but this guy will eat anything it can get its bird-like beak around. Sea sponges, algae, and even venomous jellyfish. A lot of the stuff on their menu is inedible for most, but their body fat can absorb the venom and toxins, so they go unscathed. The Bermuda Triangle is also home to green glowworms. They're not really worms, but larvae. They produce that bright light from an organ near their tail. This light makes smaller creatures come toward them, making it easy for them to catch their lunch. Most of the time, they look pretty ordinary, but they have an oddly fixed schedule. Every third night after the full moon during the summer, at an exact time, the glowworm lights up. But back to more nightmarish creatures of the Bermuda Triangle. There's the goblin shark, known as a living fossil because it's the only one left of its animal family. It's only about the length of your forearm and looks like nothing special. But watch closely as its lunch gets too close. Boom! The shark's jaw shoots out of its mouth and grabs onto the unlucky creature. Once the teeth have locked in, the jaw goes right back in the shark's mouth. And yes, you share the planet with this thing.